Hi. Options should be easily accessible, searchable, instantly previewable, and relevant to most users. That's why this Quadjar has compact but nice list of options, a small color palette, and a hotkeys that are of interest. You can navigate and change options using keyboard only. There is now a nice colors dropdown, where you can choose from some of the predefined color schemes. You can also fork any of these to create custom color scheme. You get a nice color picker. When this option is turned on, user gets to choose two color schemes, light and dark. This is useful for users who like to change colors in OS and apps depending on the time of the day. Each option can be restored to its default value. Options can be still changed by manually editing config file. Changes are applied instantly. Although this Quadjar strives to offer freedom of changing pretty much every hotkey, it still aims for same defaults that most users will never have to change. These include standard hotkeys for text editing and navigating scroll lists. Users can assign multiple hotkeys to a same command. For instance, Quadjar provides a thin layer for a Vim-like movement commands. You can even bind a hotkey sequence to a command. Pressing C twice triggers the command. If multiple commands are assigned with the same hotkeys, Quadjar will report a conflict, which you can then resolve by removing or changing one of the hotkeys. Commands can be pinned, the same way context menu items can. This makes it super useful for actions that you trigger often. For instance, toggling system and hidden entries. Some of these commands can be triggered from the UI. GoTo also got a bit of visual rework, storing everything under drop-down sections for easier navigation. Fuzzy searching now supports synonyms. If you type home, it will find your home directory, even if it doesn't contain that word. Context menu got small updates too. Besides visual changes that make it look similar to other pop-ups, nested items are now displayed inline, giving better overview. That's all for this time. I hope you are getting hyped up as I am. Sign up for the upcoming alpha and join us on the Discord server for more discussion. See you all next time.